I'm Sleepy American, and welcome to the MAP tape. I'm an advocate for invisible disabilities, including narcolepsy and all of its symptoms. I have cataplexy and sleep paralysis. It regards hallucinations and sleep attacks quite severely. And neuroscience is essential because our immune systems are able to one kick in the hypothalamus and might have to bring the hypoxygen orexin cells. And it throws your whole life on a whole different track. I haven't been able to drive since 2003. It's been a different kind of life. But I've tried to make it my own with being an invisible disability advocate and superhero. I've also watched my grandmother on my mother's side. I've watched her decline slowly to death with Alzheimer's disease, and it's very heartbreaking to watch. Right after my first husband abandoned me, 2 weeks till eviction, I really relied on my grandmother. She helped comfort me, and I helped comfort her. Watching someone slowly disintegrate due to any kind of disability illness is so traumatic. When it affects the brain and the memories, they may not remember you or your name or your memories together. It's very sad at times. There's always happiness and joy with my grandmother. It's just proved that ever since I was an academic decathlon in high school, I've been especially interested in the brain. Because it's one of the organs that can reconnect and rewire itself. And if when one sentence is one half of the brain is cut, it can reteach itself to use the other hemisphere for its own same as before uses, since it's the left side controlling the right arm and vice versa. There are so many wonderful things about the brain that make us who we are. Our personalities, our language, our memories, our judgment. All of these things are sort of right here. And that's why it's a definitive factor in figuring out if someone's really not coming back, not needing or not appropriate to be necessitated, and that would be in the event of brain death. Once there's brain death, there's not really much else that you can do or hope for, because it is the essential organ would be the brain, second to the heart. The heart is second. That's why I believe neuroscience is essential. Is it can feel emotion very safely. It can be quite difficult to feel emotions or go out in public in fear of someone laughing or saying something inappropriate. I try to educate people as nicely as possible. It's just so central to forget. Assessing why neuroscience is essential. This is the MAP tape, and I'm Sleepy American of Sleepy American Heroes. And you can visit me online at www.sleepyamerican.com. And I hope you have a naptastic time of day.